just looking at everyone like me, absolutely horrified by fucking Apple's trying to control your videos and your photos. Basically, if you use iTunes to download your personal videos and photos, they will lock them in and you can't do a single fucking thing, including delete them from your phone. You can go to a photo and hit select. There's no delete button. They own your shit. When you open up iTunes, they will drive you fucking nuts with trying to get you to sign into iTunes. You can't do shit, okay? Say I want to delete a photo from this phone, it deletes it from my fucking iPad. Instead of, you know, just letting me control my own stuff. Now, you can use a third-party app. How much trust do I have in third-party apps? Not a single fucking tiny bit. You see, we should be able to click and drag photos right to our goddamn phone. There should be a folder that allows us to click and drag from our PC, not Mac, because if you use iTunes, it creates a folder for you that says, from my Mac. And they are locked into your phone. The only way to get those fucking things off, and I tried yesterday, oh, well, just go in and click on the folder and they'll disappear. No, fuck you, that doesn't work. Thank you for more misinformation on Google about how to do something on your phone. This is why there's no owner's manual for your iTunes, because if you actually read what was in there, you'd be horrified at the lack of control and fidelity that you have over your own device. Over your own property, your music, your photos, your videos, okay? Apple doesn't want you controlling those on their device. This is not your phone. This is fucking Apple's phone. It's not my iPad. This is fucking Apple's iPad. Using iTunes. So basically it forces you to import videos to your iTunes library first. Only then can you transfer it over to your iPhone. It's a two-step process. iTunes on Windows isn't good, and there are much better media library alternatives out there. Also, iTunes doesn't support very many formats, and it's deleting media on other devices, affecting other devices. As a result, I personally don't use iTunes to put videos on my phone anymore. Using third-party PC and Mac applications. Yeah, it's fucking, yeah, I knew it. So the best transfer method this guy is trying to push is a fucking monthly service. Motherfucker. And if you discontinue the monthly service, then your fucking videos and photos are now unusable. Stuck on your phone. Now you have to do a restore. Ah, Jesus. Automatically adds artwork and metadata. Yeah, thank you. Maybe I don't want you to do that. What the fuck? Wow. You know, I've been waiting forever for a fucking iPhone that will act like an iPhone and allow me to put like a 1 gigabyte SD memory card in here. Oh no, Apple doesn't want you fucking putting any type of media in your phone that it can't control. So think about this. You download your photo from your PC to your phone and you can't delete it. You can't upload it to YouTube. You can't fucking send it via iMessage. You can't use it in any fucking way other than look at it. I'm trying to understand why they need so much fucking control over my property. I can tell you, I found out a long time ago why there's no owner's manual or instruction manual for an iPhone or an iPad. That is because if you read it, you would be fucking horrified. Okay? Apple hides so much ugly, horrible corporate bullshit, okay, behind a fucking secrecy shield that you never get to see. Most people never read their EULA. I've had to tell everybody, set your photos to keep original. Don't let fucking iTunes, you know, turn it into an Apple-only photograph. Don't fucking do that. Keep originals. Always. It will be the highest quality. It'll be, you know, your standard JPEG format. Don't let fucking Apple control your shit. High efficiency. Oh, they make it sound so wonderful, don't they? Or how about uploading photos to the cloud? So you take a photo that's very important to you and you upload it to the cloud. And now to make space on your phone, you delete it from your phone because it's in the iCloud. Well, this is the problem. If you read their fucking user agreement, what they're telling you with a big warning in giant capital bold format. Warning. Your video and your photos will be compressed to a fucking point where they're useless. When you download this from iTunes, it's not going to be what you put up into the cloud. It's going to be not even an MP3 version of your fucking photograph. It won't be 4K, 60 frame video. It will be shit. Maybe 420. Only visible, watchable on a small screen iPhone. That's why I spent so much money on camera gear for my granddaughter. So that I could simply take the chip out of my fucking GoPro, slap it in there, save it to family photos. And Apple, just keep your fucking nose out of my business. Wow. It's horrifyingly disgusting. It really is. Apple controls everything about your phone and everything you put or want to use on it. Just fucking horrifying. You know, I think the last iTunes I liked was iTunes 9. You could literally take a playlist you have over here on your fucking PC desktop and click and drag it and drop it right onto your fucking iTunes main page. You open up the playlist, there's nothing in there. You grab your songs, you drag it over and drop it. There's a new playlist. Boy, they stopped that shit right fucking now, huh? As soon as the store came along where they went, oh, well, look, we can charge people $1 for a song. That means it'll take $20,000 to fill up their iPod. Oh, fuck, we'll be billionaires. They weren't thinking of us. They weren't thinking of us, okay? Apple is one of the, I mean, they have this secrecy shield that they've wrapped themselves in, okay? But they are every bit as fucking disgusting as the worst companies that exist.